goals, fashion, shows, trap, house, I made it, gold, control the bag now, no need to brag now, no need, and put the mask down, man, living fast now, finest, oh, finest, rolls, we can go, we coast, gold, keep watching me, when we fuck, still be real and fake, that's what my dogs in the nighttime. Twisted like a stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry. Whip it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry. I'll take a whip it intermission, let the birds fly. I get money, turn no vision through my third eye. Money, yeah, that skillet, watch me flip it like it's five guys. Look at my pilgrim, check out the ceiling, look at the blue sky. Blue sky.
Yo. We live, baby. What's up? What's up? What's up? Welcome to the Drinks and Discussion Podcast, man. It's your boy King Bot, KVNG, BAK. Did I surprise you? Did you not know we were going live already?
I did not know.
Oh, okay. My bad, dog. My bad. All right, man. I'm your boy King Bot, KVNG, BAK. Got my man Primetime Naeem in here with me.
Yo, what's good?
Man, we are on episode 126. This is 126, man. 126.
Getting up there, bro.
Yeah, man. I'm ready to hit the 200s. I'm ready to hit the 200s, and I hope that, and we'll be, you know, we won't be able to get that by the end of the year, but we'll be close though. We'll be close. Yeah, 2023. I think for episode 200, I want to do a that'll be the live podcast. By then, we should be able to do a live podcast, man.
I hope so.
I'll have all the ins and outs worked out for that. So we'll do a live podcast for episode 200. I'm just gonna keep that in the brain. Where do we start, man? Did you watch that Ye documentary, dog?
I did not.
Okay.
I didn't even know nothing about the documentary.
Yeah, so Kanye has a documentary on Netflix, man, and it's actually pretty dope, man. I like how, you know, he's been like recording this shit his entire fucking career, man. And it's like, yo, to have the wherewithal to know that you're gonna be a fucking superstar, you know, when you're first starting off, that shit is fucking wild to me, man. That shit is fucking wild. Like I wonder, did niggas think he was crazy for, you know, having recorded himself? You know what I'm saying? Like,
yo, I ain't even gonna lie to you, bro. Like, I've even thought about doing that my damn self, bro. Just recording my journey.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because you just never know where you're gonna end up. So, like, on some real, like, I've even thought about doing that. Like, man, maybe. But let's see. That just goes to show the confidence he had in himself.
You know, right.
Because, you know what I'm saying? Like, I be thinking about doing that shit, but I'm like, nah, man, ain't nobody, you know what I'm saying, ain't gonna be watching it. I ain't gonna be nobody. But if I have the confidence that Ye has, then you know, like, yeah, man, go ahead, record this, because I'm gonna be big one day. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, bro, that's respect, bro. I wish I had Ye's confidence, bro.
Absolutely, man. I think I'm right there with you, man. Because, I mean, shit, imagine, like, if we would have just been recording, or if I would have, like, started, like, doing, like, behind-the-scenes recording for the podcast, and then this shit just blows up one day, then I'd be like, fuck it, bro. Let's make a Netflix documentary about this shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, it goes
from a podcast to being a fucking standalone TV show type shit, like, you know what I'm saying, like The View or some shit, you know what I'm saying? That's the male View.
So we need to start getting some behind the scenes cut.
Yeah.
So that way, years later, you know, we put this in a little documentary or whatever.
Absolutely.
See, like, you know, the ins and outs, the drama behind the scenes.
It's no drama. There's no drama.
Hush, man. You want people to buy the documentary, you gotta.
It's enticing. It gets the people going.
Tons of drama. Fights. Arguments. No.
Yeah. I don't even think they believe that. But it would be nice to do, though. It would definitely be nice to do.
I mean, but, you know, just in the simple fact of, you know, if, you know, we ever was to blow, you know what I'm saying, people could just see the journey of, like, how we, you know, where we came from, and, you know, where we at now.
So. Absolutely. Absolutely. I think that'll be ideal.
Everybody loves a success story.
You think so?
Everybody loves a success story.
I think so too, man. I think so too. So you had brought up some interesting shit after the podcast yesterday. But where you want to start at? So we got a couple places we can start. Where you want to start at?
It's most going into it. We can start at the top, man.
Okay. All right. So I've been thinking about this, and I think that let me see how I'm gonna put this. I think that with relationships, in regards to relationships, it's always the question of who changed the most when the relationship goes bad. Because a woman is always quick to pull, oh, I've done this, this, and that for you. I stopped doing this, this, and that for you. I started doing this, this, and that for you, and this is how you're going to treat me, or this is what you do. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's always like thrown in the man's face. But honestly, who really changes more, men or women, when they get into relationships? Because you change. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, you get a commitment with somebody and you change. So who changes the most?
I think we're all victims of this. And I think we gotta be specific too, because sometimes there's change for the better and then there's change for the worse. All right, but let me just talk. I'm gonna tell you my personal experience, but first I'm gonna just talk in generalizations, right?
All
right. So typically, this is what happens when you go into a relationship, and I feel like it happens on both sides, right?
Mm-hmm.
You go into a relationship, and for obvious reasons, you want to put your best foot forward because you want the person to, you know, to like you. You know, you want to put on a certain image of yourself.
Right.
A lot of times what happens is guys will start off taking girls out to eat, taking them out to dinner, going here, going there, buying them gifts unexpectedly, and then once they got you locked in, then all that shit stops. And they're just like, man, let's just chill in the house. Let's just chill in the house. Let's just chill out. The little small gifts start coming, and yada, yada, yada.
Yeah.
And then on the other side, with women, you know, when y'all first started dating, she's getting her hair all nice. She got her makeup. She got on the best outfit. And then, like, next thing you know, you know, she's showing up with the shower cap on and the, you know what I'm saying?
Let me say something to that real quick. Yo, shorties, bonnets is made for inside the house. Do not have your hair in a bonnet at 2 p.m. outside. You know what I'm saying? If you 2 p.m. in your house and you ain't going nowhere, no problem with that. I understand. However, if it's 2 p.m. and you out running errands and shit, come on, man. Come on, man. With a bonnet on, like, yo, that, I hate that shit. I hate that shit. I hate them fuzzy ass fucking house slippers that they wear everywhere. And it's something else that I hate. It's something else that I fucking hate. And I'm trying to think of what it is. It's not coming to me right now. But it's something else that I fucking hate. That, oh, man. The fuck is it? Oh. Them fucking dirty ass Uggs that y'all fucking wear. Yo, shorty, Uggs ain't even that much. You can go buy yourself a new pair. Like, you can't have like a whole new outfit and these dirty ass tan Uggs. Like, come on, man. We gotta do better, yo. We got to fucking do better, man. Please, just buy a new pair of Uggs, yo. They not even that much. You know what I'm saying? Or wear a different shoe. Wear a different shoe. That's it. That's all I got to say.
So I will say there's that. Now, I don't know if this is where you're going with it, just as far as effort. Like, people, like, they change as far as their effort.
Okay.
But I've also, in my own personal journey, is understand, like, personal growth. Like, mm-hmm. It's not even about effort, but just, like, personal growth and, like, being a different person. One of my relationships early on, I was with this lady, things were like when I got with her, like I felt like she was out of my league. You know what I'm saying? Like I felt like, oh my God, like I don't even know why this girl wanna be with me.
Do I know this lady?
Yeah,
you know. Okay. I'll just make sure it's the same one.
Right. I don't even know why this girl wanted to be with me, yada yada yada. But then I started to get older and then I started to mature more. And then I started to realize like, yo, like, and because it's funny, when she got with me, I was immature.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I think that's why it worked in the beginning because, you know, I was immature. But then I grew up, I matured, and then I was like, yo, you're kind of immature. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then, you know, we had that dynamic where it's just like, yo, you really need to grow up when it comes to certain shit in certain situations.
Right.
And, you know, I was in my, like, early 20s, so I was doing a lot of growth at this particular time.
Right.
And so, yeah, she was just pretty much the same person.
Throughout. Yeah.
And, like, you know, after, I don't know, it was like a year and a half, like, I was like, I changed significantly.
Okay.
And so, there's that, but I don't, yeah. So I feel like there's that aspect too. It just,
okay.
You know, she didn't grow with me, and I feel like life was, you know, there was so many things happening in my life. And I think part of it too was, you know, she didn't really have too much shit going on in her life, and you know, if you guys or girls, if you get with somebody, and you see that they're on their path, they're on their purpose, they're doing this and that. Or no. Let me reverse that. If you're on your purpose and you're doing this and you're doing that and you got places to be and so forth, make sure you get with someone who's also on their purpose and on their path and, you know, is motivated. Because what happens is you're going to end up at a completely different place in life than that person. And so you got to ask yourself if you're okay with that. Because, you know, you're doing this and that, and you're, you know, all these things are happening in your life. You're having all this growth, and this person just like, oh, no, I'm just kicking it at the crib, chilling, da da da. You know what I mean?
So, mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's if you're going dating somebody, that's definitely something to consider, because that's definitely, just speaking from my personal experience, what happened to me in my relationship and how it ended very, very badly.
I got it. So I think, I personally think, bro, you made a good point with the efforts. Efforts do change. Mm-hmm. And it's sad to see. But I honestly think there's another aspect to it as well. So, you know, I think men have to do the most changing, and this is why. So as a single man, you know, you go out and you can have fun with your boys and you kind of maneuver life. You know what I'm saying? Like really just looking out for yourself. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, then you have to, and you know, kind of be aware that, you know, somebody is going to be, you know, checking for your safety. You know, when you get into a relationship, oh, you going out with the boys? Oh, you know, let me know when you make it back home. You know what I'm saying? Like, not to say that, you know, you can't hang out with your boys, but you know what I'm saying? It might be certain niggas that you can't hang out with no more. Like it might be that one homeboy that you are his designated wingman. You know what I'm saying? You might not be able to kick it with that nigga like you used to, because you know that the optics aren't going to look good if her friend just happens to be at said establishment y'all go to, or she happens to be at said establishment y'all go to. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, and the world's small, man. So, you know, if you date somebody, you know what I'm saying, even, you know, in the same town or two towns over, you know what I'm saying? Like, they know somebody that knows somebody that know you and see you out. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, you know, you always got to kind of conduct yourself differently as a guy. It's different. It's different for women, because it's like, all right, take our Vegas trip, for instance, right?
Okay.
Say we had maybe, I don't want to say unsavory, but some uncouth homeboys, you know what I'm saying? That was always on some fuck shit. But, you know, them the guys, right? So, you know, saying that, oh, I'm going out to Vegas to your significant other is like, well, who the fuck going?
Right.
Oh, fucking Aaron is going? Oh, no, you know how y'all niggas be. I don't like that. Now it's a whole,
right.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta, as a guy, you really have to pick and choose what you say. You know what I'm saying? You have to be like constantly aware of not even the woman's emotions, her body, yo. Because like, you know, women's body go through these changes, right? So you have to be always complimenting her, because she may wake up one day and look in the mirror and say, oh, I'm fat as hell, knowing she's not really fat.
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you look at her, you're like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Your body is right. Yeah. But, you know, she's like, oh, I'm fat as hell. Like, no, you're not. Like, your shit is good. I'm content with what you got going on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't want you to change the damn thing. But to her, oh, I'm so fat. You know, I can't fit this favorite pair of jeans that I like to wear. Or, you know what I'm saying? My leggings is busting at the seams. To a nigga like me, shit, that ass getting fat. What up? I mean, let me touch on that joint real quick, Johnny. Brother, pow, you know? But yeah, man, I think, you know, we have to be aware of all this stuff. And I think guys do the most changing, because, you know, for women, God, man, I hate that. It sounds like fucking misogyny, bro. Like, I can't even build the wherewithal to say it, but like, women just continue doing the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Now, however, you know, you might, women take, you know, take that extra care to get ready, but I mean, they were doing that to get the guy. So is it really change? And then, you know, once they got the guy, they tend to kind of fall off, you know? Instead of getting your nails done every 2 weeks, you might get them done once a month. And it's just like, damn. You know what I'm saying? I kind of like when you keep your grippers right. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, that shit kind of turns me on during sex, and you grab my shit and your grippers right. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it kind of turns me on that you know, you not walk around with the fucking messy bun. You know what I'm saying? You keeping your hair done or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Whether you keep it in braids, whether you got locks, whether, you know what I'm saying? You got a, you know, just got a well-kept wig, whatever. You know what I'm saying? It kind of turns a nigga on sometimes when you keep that shit right. Like, you know, so it's like, damn, I ain't, you know.
I feel what you're saying in the aspect of, because I just feel like women are different when they get in a relationship versus guys.
Okay. Right?
See, a guy will get in a relationship and he doesn't want to give up too much when he gets into a relationship, right?
Right.
Still want to kick it with his boys. He still want to play ball on the weekend. He still want to play Call of Duty at night or 2K, you know what I'm saying, at the crib. He still wants to do all those things. Where I feel like women are more willing to, like, give up their life for a man.
Mm-hmm.
Which makes sense, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, women are typically going to be in the support role, you know what I'm saying? And so they're going to be more like all about you, you know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on? Like, I can't tell you how many situations where, like, girls tell me, like, oh, so-and-so got a boyfriend now. She don't even talk to me. Like, completely, like, you know what I mean? Like, they will completely
immerse themselves with the nigga.
Right, and cut off their whole crew. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they don't even exist no more as soon as they get a man. You know what I mean? They're just all about the man. They're all about the man. And so, because, you know, they're so, that, like, they're already willing to, like, just give up everything and be all about you. You know what I mean? Now it's like you who has to change your ways, because she's like full on, like, what are we doing today? What are we doing tomorrow? And you're like, oh, well, shit, tomorrow's going to go kick it with Bot. You know,
yeah, like, right.
You know, so it's like the whole thing, they're over here making all these future plans and stuff like that. So I feel like, as far as the dudes, it's like, we got to, we got to make all these, what's the word I'm looking for?
Adjustments?
Adjustments, there you go. Mm-hmm. We got to make all these adjustments, you know what I mean, to kind of like accommodate the woman, you know what I'm saying? So I do feel like in that aspect, like, we do got to do more. Now, it's, you know, kind of to your point, like, hanging with single dudes. And I was like, oh my God, he's single. He out here doing this. And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Or why he ain't got no woman? Why y'all ain't set him up with nobody? Right, you just be hanging with a whole bunch of single niggas. You be acting single when you go out.
I know he talked to women. So what you doing? Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You gotta switch up
what we because that, because that birds of a feather mentality. Like, I'm my own man at the end of the day. I can go out and hang out with a whole bunch of single dudes and be in a relationship and not do no wild shit. Because 9 times out of 10, when I go out, with my boys, I'm normally the voice of reason. And that speaks a lot to the woman not even, you know, taking time to know the man. Because if you don't, you should know your man. Ladies, you should know your man, right? So you should know what role your man plays in his group of friends. You know, is he the nigga that's, you know, that starts the party off? You know what I'm saying? Is he the nigga that's, you know, too fucking smooth for his own good? Is he the nigga that plays dad when they go out? You know what I'm saying? To make sure everybody gets to the destination that they're going. You know what I'm saying? If a nigga gets too drunk, does he walk that nigga back to the room? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit like that. Like, does he take up that mantle? Because, I mean, everybody has that. You know what I'm saying? Everybody, I mean, shit, like, Vegas, you know, one of our homeboys got a little too intoxicated. Now, mind you, I didn't really even know homes like that. I know him, but I don't know him. But I took it upon myself to be like, yo, I'm going to go ahead and get homie back to the room. You know what I'm saying? I'll be back. You know what I'm saying? I'll make sure this nigga lay down type shit. You know what I mean? Like, but I did that, you know, and it's like, you know, I have that role. Like, I made sure that I knew, you know, not the whereabouts of everybody, but just, you know, just make sure, all right, niggas, we meeting up at this time. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody, y'all getting ready? Like, you know what I'm saying? Well, we got moves to make. All right, nigga, let's call this Lyft. Let's call this Uber. You know what I'm saying? So we can get to wherever we need to get to, you know? And it's like, you just got to know, ladies, just know your man and know his role in his friend group. You know what I'm saying? Because that'll ease your mind a whole lot. You know what I'm saying? Which segues into another point, you know what I'm saying? Women overthinking. Because that is probably the biggest downfall of most relationships, is that women fucking overthink too much. You know, I can't be with a woman who doesn't have other shit going on in her life, because it leaves too much time for her to think of some fucking wild ass allegation or accusation and try to be like, well, I just find it funny how, wait a minute, it doesn't even make sense. Like, you overthought this entire process. You know what I'm saying? Oh, well, you said you were going to this bar and you ended up going to another bar. Yeah, because the plans changed. Like, you know what I'm saying? Or what's the Kevin Hart joke? He's talking about going out with his boys, and his wife is like, well, where the fuck y'all going? I don't know. Figure out when we get there. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, niggas meet in a fucking parking lot and be like, all right, nigga, like, I got 2 hours before my girl start calling. We need to make plans and whose car are we getting in, because I need to, you know, send out this information, this fucking itinerary. You know what I'm saying? Like, it shouldn't have to be like that. If I say I'm going out with the boys, I'm going out with the boys. That's it.
Yeah, man, I feel like, you know, yeah, one, they need, like, hobbies or something going on to keep them occupied. But two, like, it has to be a certain level of security, right? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, women are so insecure with themselves sometimes, man. You know, they get real jealous, you know what I mean? They got real jealous and they get insecure and they think, you know, you're looking at every single girl or every, you know what I mean? Every single girl who pops up is competition or, You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like they just need to, like, just chill out. Like, you know what I mean? Stop being the busybody. Stop. You know what I mean? Like, like when I be like, yo, I'm going out with my boys, just be like, all right, have fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. You know, there's no need for this 20 questions. Like, oh, where you going? Who you going with? How long are you going to be gone? Then, like, yo, just be like, all right, don't stay out too late. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right. Yo. Bigger facts.
Like, I love that shit, bro. I love that shit. And I think, like, one thing is that women is like, y'all don't understand, like, the level of importance of not being a headache to your man. You know what I'm saying? So when you're always asking them questions and, you know what I mean, asking all them questions, you know what I'm saying? Just, like, you know, interrogating him about this, this, that, and the third, like, bro, you're interrupting that man's peace. You know what I'm saying? He's just like, yo, chill. Like, you know what I mean? So he doesn't want to hear all that. So, like, if you want to be, if you love your man and you want to be his peace, the one thing you got to do is you got to chill out on the interrogations, all the questions, all that stuff. It's unnecessary at the end of the day.
Yeah, I could dig that. I could dig that. What's okay? So, what kind of roles do you? Cause you like the king of this shit, man. So what kind of roles have you seen, you know what I'm saying, like women take on this, you know, on this, I want to say newfound religion of relationships, because they honestly treat this, well, people, I'm not just saying women, but people honestly treat this shit as a fucking religion, and they play these fucking roles like alpha women.
Yeah. So, what's the question?
Well, do you believe? Okay, so we talked off air about it, but okay, do you believe in the role of the alpha woman?
The role of the alpha woman. Mm-hmm. All right. So this is very interesting, because I feel like there is a divide on whether an alpha woman even exists or don't exist. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Reason being is because when you talk about being an alpha, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there's different takes on even what an alpha is, even like amongst like alpha men, like what is an alpha male, right?
Right.
So in this whole discussion, I had to really think about like, all right, well, first off, let's break down what an alpha is. You know what I'm saying? Like, what is that? You know? So an alpha is someone who dominates a room.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? When I mean dominate a room, it's like as soon as they walk in the room, the presence is felt. When they talk, people listen. There's someone that, you know, people look up to. You know, there's someone who walks their own path. You know, they don't worry about what other people are doing. You know, they're confident, all this good stuff.
Mm-hmm. They set the trend.
Yeah. And so I feel like where the question is there such thing as an alpha woman? I feel like the reason why some people don't believe that there is a such thing as an alpha woman is because an alpha woman, like the woman would have to defer to the man if she was ever in a relationship.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So it's really, you know what I mean? The man would always be the alpha in that situation.
Right.
However, I do believe that there is alpha women amongst women.
Okay.
Not alpha women amongst men, because I feel like that doesn't quite equate.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because you know what I'm saying? It's like she can be the lead, you know what I mean, amongst her crew.
Yeah.
But everybody know, like right, it's a man's world, bro. Like I hate to say that, Drake, but like it's
misogyny.
Misogyny. It's a man's world. Like guys are we're just so much fun. We're just so much fun. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we're gonna be out here. We're going to be doing dumb shit. We're going to get the party live. You know what I'm saying? Like, you put too many, Like, you put too many women in the same room, man, they're going to be...
It's going to be some fucking drama.
It's going to be some drama. It's going to be some catfighting. It's going to be all type of shit. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, 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 but yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, guys, bro, like we will get the event going, bro. We will get any kind of shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we just know, we like, it moves on us, bro. Like,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
We get this shit live, so it's like, you know,
you put a bunch of guys on a trip, you know, as long as they are not the of the bitchier men variety, everybody's gonna still be friends at the end of the trip. But if you put a group of women on a trip, guaranteed it's gonna be a divide when y'all get back, you know what I'm saying? Or loss of a friend. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't see too many girl trips between the 20s and, excuse me, about mid to late 30s, somewhere around there. That little fucking window right there. Yeah, y'all. I mean, I'm not gonna say y'all shouldn't take trips with y'all friends. Just be mindful who you take trips with.
It gotta be like close friends. Cause look, bro. Like, all right, for instance, right? Speaking of trips, right?
Okay.
I brought my boy Antoine, right?
Yeah.
And you were the only one who knew Antoine. Nobody else knew Antoine.
Yeah.
But dude got along with everybody. You know what I'm saying? He, matter of fact, he was gone. You know what I mean? Kicking it with AJ, Amir.
Yeah.
They just met on that trip.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And everything was cool, copacetic, bro. No drama, no. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, bruh, I can tell you how many times I talk to women who just came back from a trip. They're like, I mean, it was all right, but, you know, so and so was complaining.
Yeah, I ain't get to do what I wanted to do. Like, you know what I'm saying?
To do, and then I'm like, bro, what the hell, bro? Like, y'all don't know how to, like, mix and match, bro, because you know how many times we, like some of us would go do this, the other sometimes other, like, it's cool. Like, we ain't all got to do the same shit. And, bro, that, to me, that speaks about alpha mentality, too, and about, like, alphas being able to coexist is that, you know, because when an alpha says, oh, I'm about to go do this, another alpha will be like, either I want to do that or nah, I'm going to go do this and it's no problem. You get what I'm saying? Yep. Like, you know what I mean? Well, a beta, even though he don't want to do it, he'd be like, well, all right, man, I ain't want to do it, but I'll go along with it. You know what I'm saying? Where alpha would just be like, nah, yo, y'all go ahead, have fun, man. I'm going to just chill. You know what I'm saying? Because an alpha, you know what I mean?
He sets the tone.
He sets the tone. He walks to the beat of his own drum. Yep. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, like, people, you know, there was another talk of, like, you know, can alphas coexist? But, yeah, because alphas are cool. They calm. They don't give a fuck what you're doing.
Yeah.
Alphas thrive. I will say this. Alphas thrive better when there isn't other alphas. You know what I'm saying? Because they get to shine more.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what I mean? Like, alphas, you know what I mean? They move to the beat of their own drum. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, but boy, y'all women, Lord of mercy.
I'm telling you, man. It's something different, man. It's something different with these women, man. I think that, I don't know, man. It's, I don't believe in there not being an alpha woman role. However, I do think that shit shifts, because to be a true alpha, you're not always an alpha. You know what I'm saying? Take Lions for instance, right? So you got, you know, when they depict Lions, you know what I'm saying? They show the alpha male, mm-hmm, and all the women. Mm-hmm. However, you know what I'm saying? It's always at least one or two other males around. You know what I'm saying? And at some point in time, they step up into that alpha role.
Right, right.
You know, they step up into that alpha role.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just the way the world works. The world is, we live in a world of fucking divine reciprocation. Because everything has to be reciprocated at some fucking point in time.
Right. And see, this is why, like, I don't even prescribe to that whole notion of dudes talking about, like, yeah, I'm an alpha male. I'm a da da da. First off, bro, if you gotta say you're an alpha male, you're probably not an alpha male. Mm-hmm. That's one. Two,
Unless you pledge, then you are an alpha male. Right.
but the second thing is, you know, alpha, being an alpha has a certain level of dominance. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have to be dominant to, you know, like, enjoy life, or, you know what I mean, be secure with yourself, be confident. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like that alpha phrase, you know, like you said, like, you're not going to be dominant at all times or not all areas. So the whole thing about being dominant is really, to me, like, that's not so important in the grand scheme of things. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's not like you need to be dominant in order to, you know, get a job, or dominant to get women. You know what I mean? Or whatever the case may be.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And I was having a conversation with my homeboy, and he was saying that shit was bullshit too, because, you know what I mean, like, let's say you're an introvert, right? Because I feel like almost too is like that alpha, that alpha title is almost reserved for extroverts. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, let's say, because they talk about alphas, they walk in a room and, you know what I mean, all the attention's on them. But what if you, like, you're introverted? You know what I'm saying? Like, you walk in, you're confident, you don't mind speaking to people, but you're just chilling. You know what I'm saying? Like, what? Yeah. Like, you walk into a party and you just, or not even a party, but like a get together, and you're just chilling and you're just observing, and you're just like, oh, okay, you know what I mean? You sipping your drink and, you know, you chime in here and there and whatever, you know what I'm saying? See, that's the thing. Like, people, you know what I mean? Like, people won't picture that guy as an alpha because he doesn't walk in, he doesn't capture the room, because he's just chilling. He's okay with blending in the background, but that doesn't mean he's not confident. That doesn't mean he's not sure of himself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
sometimes you just want to scope the fucking scene.
Right. And I feel like I think they got another term called the Sigma males or whatever. I don't even want to get into all of that, but you know what I'm saying?
That's a whole nother fucking right. Can
of worms. I think like the Sigma, yeah, it's supposed to be like a quiet alpha male or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, to me, the best type of male to be is a masculine man. And I think that encompasses everything that you need to be when in all situations. You know what I'm saying? And you don't have to be, like I said, you don't have to dominate a room, or you don't have to, like, be, like, the center of attention, or, like, someone's role model necessarily, whatever. You know what I mean? Like, look up to. You just a dude who handles your shit.
Yeah, absolutely. And you keep it of being like that, man. Like, I don't think that, you know. So, I mean, 9 times out of 10, like, if I come somewhere, like a gathering or something, normally the loudest person in the room, or the loudest man, knock the damn mic off. Normally, like, the loudest male in the room is like the is probably not the person that I would gravitate towards,
right?
Just because it's like, bro, why you gotta be so loud, dog? Like, you can mellow out and just, you know, get a feel for it. Like, and that used to be my thing. Well, that still is my thing. So, you know, if I get into a room full of people, 9 times out of 10, I'm people watching, right? And I know who I'm going to gravitate towards, or who's going to give me, I guess, the best output or experience, you know, conversation wise, because it's like, you know, okay, I've watched you, and you maneuver like a person that I would have a good conversation with. And that's normally what happens. Like, if I go out to the bar, if I go out, you know, to a game night at somebody's crib, like, you know what I'm saying, just a kickback or something, man, like, I know who I'm going to gravitate towards, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, just be masculine and be observant. That's it, man. You know what
legit,
I'm saying?
Legit, yeah. Man. I feel like that's all you need, man. That's all you freaking need, right?
So you posed a question. Are women better cheaters than men?
All right, man. So this what
happened. All right, it's a story.
So this what happened, man. It's having this conversation.
Mm-hmm.
And Shorty starts going on this whole rant. She was like, first off, you know what I'm saying? Y'all dudes don't even know how to cheat. You know what I'm saying? Women, man, we way better at cheap as you dudes, man. Y'all just be out here all sloppy with it, and y'all don't even know what y'all really doing. Y'all be getting cheated on all the time. But you know what I mean? Like, us women, man, we more smooth with our shit. We more blah, blah, blah. We more this, we more this, we more blah. I'm here to call Cap. I'm here to call Cap. It's not true. Women are not better cheaters. I'm going to tell you why.
Tell me why. Why?
Truth is, you guys have an environment that allows you to get away with cheating easier than men.
Mm-hmm.
Starting with the first thing. First thing is that, one, the perception is, or at least it's starting to fade, but the perception was for a very long time that, you know, women are angels and they don't cheat as much.
Mm.
So that's the first perception. So a lot of dudes, and there's still a lot of dudes to this day who don't think, who can't even imagine their girl cheating on them.
Right.
Right. Plus, you know, like, I'm the man, you know what I'm saying? Like, she in love with me, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying? They'll be telling the boys, man, this girl is on me, bro. She, da, 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 da. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of guys, one, don't have it in their head that their girl would even cheat on them.
Right.
So because of that, like, we're not even looking for the signs that women are. Women are constantly questioning if you're talking to other women, if you're seeing other women, if you're sleeping with one. They're constantly checking for signs.
And you know, this is a bigger topic. I just want to mention it because most women live in a state of victimization. Mm-hmm. You know, they're always the victim of something, you know. Mm-hmm. And I say that because we had the conversation about picking the wrong person, having that accountability. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you can't be a victim if you hold yourself accountable to a certain degree.
Right.
You know, but go ahead.
Right. And so, and to that, like, they're always thinking that there's something wrong, even when there isn't something wrong. You know what I'm saying? If you just, like, forget to text them or some shit, like, or forget to call them, they'd be like, oh, well, what were you doing? Where were you between 5 and 4? You didn't text me that whole window of time. Like, what are you talking about? I just didn't text you. I was doing something else. My mind was busy doing something else. So it's like they are constantly checking, looking for signs of cheating.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that's one. All right? Reason number two why women are not better cheaters. You're just in an environment to cheat better. Men are much more likely to go along with the cheater. I'm going to tell you what I'm talking about.
Okay, yeah, you're going to have to explain this one to me.
And maybe, I don't know if you've been in this experience, but I've been in this experience.
Okay.
Because one, me, I'm a man who women have cheated on their boyfriends with.
Yeah, certified side niggas.
You've been a side nigga.
Yeah.
So as a side nigga, let me ask you this.
Okay.
Have you ever felt the urge to call the other guy and be like, you know what, I just wanted to
fuck no.
As a man.
Fuck no.
Let you know that your girl was cheating. Has that ever happened to
fuck
you?
Fuck no, man. Like, look, why would I fucking cut the tree down instead of just enjoying the fruit from time to time? Like, that's stupid. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because the time that you do that, that woman is not going to be fucking with you no more. Because why did you do that? Why?
All right. So, right. I mean, you just messed up your own shit. But anyway,
right.
Side chicks do their shit all the time. Hold on. This is twofolds, right?
Okay.
One.
And now we're cooking.
One. All right. So she's a side chick. She knows she a side chick, but she still get jealous or whatever and does little things to let your girl know, you know what I'm saying, that y'all fucking. Like, she might, like, meme mug her in the club.
Follow her on Instagram.
Even just all type of little breadcrumbs to the shit.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? But add to that, guys are much more likely, are much more acceptive of being the side nigga.
Mm-hmm.
I was completely cool
Right.
With being the side nigga. Were you cool with being a side nigga?
Bro, it was like being in a relationship without having all the fucking responsibility. Because it's still responsibilities to being a side nigga.
Bro.
You know what I'm saying? But you don't have all the responsibilities. You know what I'm saying? Like
being the side nigga is great.
Hey, man. Being
really great. You know what I'm
saying? I had no issue with that shit, man. It was bro. Like, you know... Hey, look, all I got to do is just is no fucking be a little Caesar's hot and ready. Oh, yeah, I'm good. I'm fucking good, nigga. Like, you know.
Tell you the joy of being the side, nigga, bro.
Just got to be up at 3 a.m., you know what I'm saying?
All the benefits without the headaches, bro. But yep. You ain't got to be on the phone with her for hours. Why? Because she going to be talking to her boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to be taking her out to an expensive restaurant or just like that because that's what her boyfriend going to be doing.
Right. You can order DoorDash at the crib because why? Why would you be out in public for
her? Be out in public so you ain't out here spending a whole bunch of cash and all this other shit.
Yeah.
But then she will come in through to the crib. So that means you ain't got to spend no money, blah, blah, blah. You do the do. Like you said, you just got to be up at a certain time of night.
Yeah.
Come through. Put
you might have to swing by the Waffle House. Maybe.
You might give a you know what I mean? Bring some food or y'all or Uber Eats or some shit.
Yeah, or if she roll with her girls, you know what I'm saying? You just pick her up from you know, from the Waffle House or whatever. You know what I'm saying? You order a plate ahead of time. So by the time you get there, your food ready, you know what I'm saying? Be like, all right, you ready to go. So when you get back to the crib, you can eat. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you might meet her at the club or some shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, buy a drink or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But you ain't doing the heavy lifting.
Right. And somebody you else, ain't doing yeah. That.
Because at the end of the day, bro, you just want to clap them cheeks and keep it pushing. You know what I'm saying? So that is the beauty of it. Because we know. So we're more, you know, accepting of that whole situation.
Right.
Whereas women, not so much. You know what I'm saying? They'll get in there and they act like they're cool with it. But then you, if you put it on them too good, then they're going to start to catch feelings. And then they're going to be like, well, hold on for a minute. Why am I such?
Yeah.
Why am I just getting... dick down and blah blah, you know what I mean? And yeah. But you take it because she'll look on your Instagram, she'll see you taking your girl on trips, she'll see you you buying your girl stuff on Valentine's Day,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And she's like, what, how come I can't post that? How come I you signed up for this, and now you having regrets, and now you want to blow up my shit because you having regrets after you signed up for this shit.
So, look, during my tenure at Central, man, I was a part of this relationship open table discussion that they had. So I think the IOTAs put on this, you know, kind of open table discussion where, excuse me, you know, it's a whole bunch of, you know, college kids. We met up in one of the rec rooms in one of the dorms or whatever. And we just kind of had an open table talk, man. And I made this point and everybody just shut the fuck up. Right. So we were talking about the anatomy of men and women, why women catch feelings and guys before guys do, you know, in a relationship or in any kind of situationship that you, you know, are involved in. Right. So, and I explained to him like this, I said, look at the anatomy of men and women, our genitalia hangs out. We can wipe our dicks off and those feelings go right in the trash can with that wet wipe. However, women is different because women, y'all genitalia is inside. You have to invite that nigga in. You know what I'm saying? You don't invite everybody to your house. You know what I'm saying? But once you get that invite the first time, normally, if you leave a good impression, you could come back. You know what I'm saying? So that's just the anatomy of fucking men and women. That's why that shit is fucking different, yo.
I like that shit.
Bro. Yeah, bro. When I said that shit, everybody shut the fuck up. They was like, damn, this nigga on to some shit, yo.
Man, this is why, man, like, I don't be understanding why, like, people don't understand the differences, the clear differences between men and women, bro. It's in our anatomy. It's in our biology, the reason that we operate differently.
Yeah.
it's built in us. That's why we operate differently, man. That's why, man, like, you know, on my podcast, man, I talk about all the time, masculine and feminine energy, bro. That whole balance there, bro, mm-hmm. is completely, you know what I'm saying? Is they're polarizing energies, man. And that's what attracts us to the other. So, absolutely, bro. Like women can't even go and hold the same. You can't hold like we hold. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? So it's completely different. It's completely different. So like women talking about how they better cheaters, but you got the advantage of one, the dude that you cheating with, he can know everything. Like I've been sitting right next to a chick while she butt naked, while she on the phone mm-hmm. with a dude, and I've been quiet as fuck. But let me do that, be talking to my girl, and the side chick there, she gonna be like trying to make noise, like smacking the TV. I'm like,
yeah, like who is that in the background? You got somebody over there? What is that noise? I'm like, yo, shut the fuck up. You know what I mean? Yeah.
So nah, bro, it's completely different. And then like my third part, first of all, man, like we wrote the book on the whole player shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like.
And to keep it a beam, man, you know, monogamy itself is a Western thing. And to be honest with you, man, I'm just gonna keep it a fucking beam. To be honest with you, man, before we got into the essence of, you know, marriage and all that shit like that, before these Western ideologies came about, man, like, yo, niggas was fucking, you know what I'm saying? You had your main chick, but you was out here fucking, yo, you know what I'm saying? Like, you was doing your thing, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't understand why, you know, it's like you're giving meaning to, like, giving meaning to a word, right? Like, what makes a cuss word a cuss word? What makes fuck so bad?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? What makes that word so bad? It's four letters. What makes that word so bad? It's the meaning behind it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's the meaning behind it. The same thing goes for the ideology of a man being with multiple women. The ideology behind it is messed up.
Yeah.
Now, am I saying that, you know, I support polygamy? Honestly, yes, because, and this is why, because I think polygamy is fucking financially and fucking emotionally inept. I would, yo, honestly, if I was to get into a polygamous relationship with two women, matter of fact, I was in a polygamous relationship with two women. So I was in a polygamous relationship with two women, dog. And, bro, that's probably the happiest relationship that I've ever been in. The only reason why that relationship didn't work is because, all right, so the women were actually married.
Okay.
And I was the male insert into that, right? Uh-huh. But it had nothing to do with me why the relationship didn't work, because I played my part. I stayed in my lane, right? However, they had issues going on between each other. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's it. And those issues were seeded well before I got there. So it had nothing to do with me. Actually, they actually both set me down when they were getting their divorce. And they both set me down and was like, yeah, we're just going to go ahead and end things. And this is why. It has nothing to do with you. I said, oh, okay. Well, shit. I appreciate you, you know, letting me know. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, and I saw the signs. So it's like, you know, it's not like I didn't see it. But, yo, that was probably the most liberating and freeing experience fucking ever, yo.
I got a funny thing to tell you, bro. Mm-hmm. I had an old boy, bro, and you know this guy. Oh, he had a girl, and his girl had a girlfriend. You know what I'm saying? And it's funny. This was during that time when that song.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You got a girlfriend.
Yo.
Chevy Blue Light Whirlwind. Yeah.
So that shit, I was like, damn, bro, your girl got a girlfriend, bro. And tell me why, bro, this shit ended because his nigga shit. His girl had a girlfriend, and then he was still fucking another chick.
Bro, why?
No, wait, bro. I love telling this story.
All right.
I love the story, bro. Because.
Nigga fucking up the church's money.
Bro. How we get caught, bro? And I don't know how he did this, bro.
He ended up
meeting a girl online who worked at the same job that one of the girls worked at. And so she telling the other girl, right? She like, oh my God, I met this guy, bro. He's all this. Oh my God.
Yeah.
And then he show up at the joint and they see this nigga and they're like, you. Oh, well, they said his name. I ain't gonna say his name.
You
the one.
Damn, son. Where'd you find this? That's fucking wild, dog.
That nigga said all he could do was laugh, bro, and that shit was
I mean, shit, at that point, that's really all you can do, man. Like, just because you stupid, bro. Like, yo. Honestly.
This fucked up a good thing, bro.
Honestly, bro. Damn, I've been in a couple polygamous relationships. Okay, so the one I was speaking about, both the women were femmes. I've been in a polygamous relationship I've been in a polygamous relationship where one of the women, you know, was a stud.
Was a stud.
Yeah, but it wasn't like a hardcore stud. It was like a femme stud. Like I don't know what you call it. They're on the borderline. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Like she'll put on a dress. But 9 times out of 10, like, she got on some fucking sweats.
As long as she don't put on a strap.
she put on a strap on for her. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah, so, like, you know, I mean, it is what it is. And I thought
that's a... smack your hand away, man. Hey, man, I ain't with that gay shit.
No, she was actually with me, you know, dicking both of them down. But, like okay. Yeah, so...
But you couldn't grab a titty or nothing like that.
Nah, nigga, I grab titties and anything. Like,
so she went like, nah, you get up, man, I ain't on that gay shit. Bro.
Yeah, she was more tomboyish. Okay. I say that.
All right, cool.
You know what I'm saying? She was like a tomboy.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah, you know what I'm saying?
There's a big difference between a stud and a tomboy.
Yeah. But I mean, she classified herself as a stud. She identified as a stud, but she...
I know, but did you give it a D?
Yeah.
She ain't a stud then.
Okay, bro, first of all, studs be out here getting dick all the time, bro. All the fucking time.
Hold on. First off, y'all be perpetrating any goddamn way, but that's neither here nor there.
That shit's funny, man. But nah, like that shit was.
Someone got bro pregnant. Bro, you see them studs coming
over? Yeah. My man, Big Ja actually did a video about that, man. So he was fucking his stud homegirl, and his homeboy found out about it and was like, yeah, you talk about E, my nigga? Yeah, that's a homie. The fuck is E doing over here late at night, nigga? Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so, and then one of the studs ended up pregnant and shit. It was funny. It's a whole skit. It's funny, man. But you know, that was probably like one of the most sexually liberating situations that I've been in. Because, all right, I'm going to tell you, at first it was scary as shit, right? Because when Shorty pulled out the strap, I was like, I was on high alert. I was just like, what's happening right now? Like, what? Where is that going? You know? And she was like, oh, nah, my nigga, you know, it's for her. I was like, okay, cool. You know what I'm saying? And then it was like, it would be like funny because like Shorty would like suck the strap while I was hitting it from the back and I would just be back there laughing because I was like, what sensation is she getting out of this shit? You know what I'm saying? Like, just shit like that. But I mean, it was eye opening. It was liberating. And I was like, okay, well, you know, I'm not, you know, closed off to this. So, you know, it's cool. I get it.
Or you're moaning and shit. Yeah. Bitch, why the fuck are you moaning? You don't feel shit.
Now, however, her strap on was a little different. So it was like the little harness shit, but on the inside of it was something that went in her. So every time that strap moved, she would get some kind of stimulation. So I understood, like, okay.
She not a real stud.
Yeah, I mean, you know.
Real studs don't like penetration.
Bro, you can't say that, bro. You can't say that. You can't say that, bro.
I never. The studs I know didn't like no penetration.
So
my auntie's. If I smacked a stud on the ass, she'd be like, what the fuck you doing, bro? I ain't on that gay shit. I'm like, damn, bro. I was like, that ass looking fat, homie. Like, what the fuck?
So my aunt's a stud. You know, I actually haven't had this conversation with her. And you know, my aunt is we've never had the conversation about, you know, her sexuality. I just understood that, you know, like when I was younger, she just always had fine ass roommates. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, now that she's older and now that I'm older, I know, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, all right, yeah, you know what I'm saying? My auntie, like, she dresses like a guy, you know what I'm saying? She's a stud. You know what I'm saying? She actually has a fiance now. They got a wedding date set, man. I'm so happy for her, man. But I definitely want to have that conversation with her just to confirm what you're saying, because like in my experience, it's like, nah, nigga, like, you know. But she's like old school, so she's like an old school stud. So yeah, in her instance, it might be that she might not like penetration. But I'm gonna ask her. I'm gonna ask her next time I see her, man. Next time I see her, you know what? Christmas, bro. I took my first shot with her, bro. Mm. Yeah, bro. It's so crazy, man. It's like, you know, when you get to a certain age around your family, man, just certain shit kind of changes, man. And be like, damn, like, I think I ain't never took no shot with you. Man, let's go ahead and take this shot. I think I was, no, I had Jack. I had Jack. She had tequila. She drinks tequila. But, yeah, I was like, damn, this is our first shot together. I'm fucking 33 years old. Speaking of which, bro, you about to be 35 this year.
And don't remind me of that shit, bro.
That's crazy. I'll be 34, bro. I'll be 34, man.
Don't remind me of that shit, bro.
I'll be 34, bro.
Because you know, after 35, now that's officially pushing 40.
Mm. You're going to be knocking on the fucking door, man. But 35, bro, we got to do something, man. I got you, bro. I got you, bro. We got to do something big for 35, though.
Let's figure it out.
Yeah, that's going to be a lit birthday, man. See, your last birthday was lit, nigga.
Yeah.
We had a ball, yeah, man.
We did have a ball.
Yeah, man. It was good times with good people. You know what I'm saying? It was something small, but I mean, we made it big. Like, we made that shit fucking grand. Like, when I went to the fucking bar at the club we went to, we packed out our section over capacity, bro. And, yeah, like, going to that bar and niggas asking, yo, who y'all? You know what I'm saying?
No, we definitely had the biggest group in the whole place.
Yeah, man. And it was just like, just the vibes to be like, you know, niggas that we've known 10 years plus to just be out there and just having a good fucking time, bro. Just a good fucking time, man. You know, the young ladies that we was with, you know, the homeboys that came through and showed you love, man. You know what I'm saying? It was just
good
like
time, bro.
Yeah. And you know, I appreciate our celebrations of life, because I won't say birthdays. Yeah. We don't celebrate birthdays, but our celebrations of life, man, like, yo, now it's fun because we actually have like the financial means to do some shit, man. And it's just like, yo, this shit is fucking crazy, man. I love this shit, man. Yeah, we got off topic like a motherfucker, man.
We show the fuck dead, bro. Wait, we was talking about polygamous relationships and shit like that, and then no, you brought up the shorty with it was a stud and shit. But hold on, because I don't want to get off that topic just quite yet.
Okay,
bro. I don't want to get off the topic just quite yet. But I guess. So would you say that? Do you think like polygamous relationships should be normalized?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yo, I see. What was the statistic that you gave the other day? Was it 60 something thousand for a household?
Yeah. 65K for a household.
Add 40 more K onto that, bro. Like, come on. Add a helping hand around the house. I won't say living babysitter, but you know, just a help with the fucking kids, yo. Like, just think about that shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, bro, that shit is fucking crazy.
You know what I would say? What I would say too? I think women would actually would enjoy a polygamous relationship, even though they don't like to admit it. I think women are more worried about what other women would say. You know what I'm saying? Like, if women could be in a polygamous relationship without feeling judged,
right,
I think more women would do it.
Right.
Because let's keep it 100. A lot of women are in polygamous relationships, whether they know it or not. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And women are hypergamous in nature, so they're all going for the same dudes. They're all going for the same dudes anyway.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And so it's like, women gonna get mad at me for saying this, but I believe that women would be, most women would be more likely to share a high value man versus selling for an average dude.
I disagree with that. I disagree with that, bro. Because
I disagree
with that, because if you put, I think that the underlying tone of women, of Western women, is a nigga needs to be with me and only me. And that's, and I mean, honestly, that's what I feel like, man. Like, I don't think that,
but why
changes.
But again, like, what, like, why is that though?
Media. Like, social fucking media.
But that's
dog.
What I'm saying. It's outside pressure that's making them like that. Here's what I'm getting to, is they can still get the exact same joy from that dude. Mm-hmm. Actually, they can. I wholeheartedly believe,
mm-hmm.
and I can pick from other people. I can pick from my own life.
Right.
That women will get more joy being with a top tier nigga who they look up to, who they, you know, who they love, versus being with a low tier dude and having not to share him. Because women all the time, like the dudes who will be loyal, like undoubtedly like loyal to them,
right?
They curb them niggas all the time.
Yeah.
Those type of dude, like, they want the dude who's capable. See, this is the thing. They want the dude who's capable of getting multiple women, but they want them to be loyal.
Okay.
But the type of guys that they go for are dudes who are with multiple women. Like, just look. I'm gonna bring up like celebrities. Trey Songz.
Yeah.
Everybody know he ain't about to be loyal. Yet women still go after him.
Yeah.
Future.
Oh yeah, no, that nigga got a baby mama for every continent, nigga.
Everybody know he ain't about to be loyal yet. Women still go after.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and maybe this is like a toxic trait for women or whatever, but like they still want that guy. Like, they want that guy, they want to be around that guy,
mm-hmm.
but they want to, like, in their mind, they want to believe, like, oh, I'm the only one, and da 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 da. Like, and I would love to have this debate with another woman or something like that. You know what I'm saying? But
I gotta find I actually have to find like a level headed woman to bring as a guest on the podcast, man.
Here's my other reason why I believe this, right? Is women constantly go back to dudes who cheat.
Hmm.
If exclusivity was so important to you, you would have never went back. But yeah, the thing is, they're with the dude who can get all the women, the smooth dude, the dude who's, you know, tall, handsome, and got money, blah, 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 you know what I'm saying? Like,
well, it sometimes it's not even that, because sometimes it, you know, it's a nigga who can sell hope the best. That's what it is.
Whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
Whatever the case may be.
Yeah,
right. Yeah. Then they go to a dude who, because a lot of times this is what happens. A lot of times what happens is, and I'm not saying this is true of all men, but a lot of times what happens is the guys who are loyal typically don't have that much options. Right.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And you'll hear Kevin Samuels say this a lot, where he says high value men don't cheat. They exercise their options.
Ooh. fuck with that. Yo, I don't know why women hate Kevin Samuels so much, because that nigga be dropping y'all jewels and y'all just be, all he do is body shame women. No, he has a preference in his head, you know, his thoughts of what a high valued woman is. And just because he portrays that and you disagree, like, yo, and then you don't even watch the whole episode. You just watch the fucking viral clips. That shit be fucking blowing me. Hey, bro, look. First and foremost, man, that nigga Kevin Samuels be dropping hella jewels.
Hell yeah.
And that shit be, oh my, it be so fucking on point. And I just be like, fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I could sit there and watch his entire shit and be like, yo, I mean, that nigga's on some shit. Now, sometimes he might say something that's a little left for me, and I'd be like, all right, I disagree with that. But the total gist of it, I'd be like, yeah, you got that shit, bro. You got that shit.
But here's my point. All right, so let me just round it off. Just round it off, bro. If you got a dude, right, who can make you laugh, makes your lady parts tingle, you know what I'm saying, knows how to wine and dine you, you know what I'm saying? Like, makes, you know what I mean? Like, makes you feel special. You know what I'm saying? Like, who's exciting. He's fun. He has all of that great conversation.
Right.
But the only caveat is he wants another woman. That's the only thing. But he has everything else. But the only caveat is
he wants another woman to spend his time with as well. But I mean, for y'all to fucking share, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, people are so closed off to, you know, you want to glorify, you know, people expressing their sexuality, but you want to close off you want to glorify women expressing their sexuality, women being gay, women, you know, choosing, you know, just not to be with anybody. Y'all want to glorify that. However, you don't want to be open to the fact of a man exploring his sexuality with saying, all right, look, I don't want to cheat on you. However, I want us to have somebody.
Bring someone in.
You know what I'm saying? And like, I know guys right now where it doesn't have to be another woman. They, you know, they want another guy. Not me, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I know guys like that. You know what I'm saying? Not to say they, you know, the guys gonna be fucking each other, nothing like that. But you know what I'm saying? Like, as a man, he knows it's like, all right, well, I think that'll be a good idea because, you know, it's something missing that I can't provide. You know what I'm saying? I understand that wherewithal. But regardless if it's another man or another woman, y'all just close that whole fucking door to that shit. Y'all not even with that shit. And it's like, damn, like, so you just want me to go out here and cheat.
And but see, here's the thing. Like, a lot of women are in relationships where the dude is cheating on them anyway. Mm-hmm. So why not just have an open situation? You know what I'm saying? Because what happens is he's cheating. You still staying with him, but you giving him shit for it, but you still staying with him. Why not just have it an open situation where it's like, it's cool. And then it's not cheating at that point.
Right.
Because the guy that a lot of you ladies are with, he cheating anyway. So why not make it a situation where it's like, all right, it's cool, blah, blah, blah. Y'all doing this, y'all doing that. And it's whatever.
Yeah. Like my thing is this, bro. My thing is this. I just,
especially if he taking care of y'all equally, like, I don't see what the problem is.
Right. And like, I mean, this is a good segue, you know, to every relationship ain't gonna be sunshine and fucking rainbows, man. Sometimes your partner is gonna be fucking slacking, you know. But if you have two partners, yo, you know how. All right, for instance, a woman may say, "Oh, my man is emotionally unavailable." But when your man's emotionally unavailable, ladies, who are you telling that to? You're telling that to your fucking homegirls. Why not have a homegirl in house that you also have a fucking physical connection with and building that emotional connection? Cause you know, your nigga falls short in that area. Like, come on, man. Shit makes too much fucking sense not to fucking work. You know, if you do it right, that shit fucking works. You know what I'm saying? If you get rid of that fucking jealousy, if you get rid of that fucking overthinking, that shit fucking works, yo. That shit fucking works, man. You know?
I'll keep it 100 with you. If I thought like Shorty's was cool with me having multiple wives, I'd be married already.
nigga, what? I'd be like, yo, like coming, like, all right, so, you know, be it both of us being Muslim, you know, we come from a society or come from a religious background, you know, and where we've seen, you know, guys with multiple wives. And those were probably the happiest guys that I've ever fucking seen. I'm just going to be honest with you. Like, Brother Scarry. Well, Scar had multiple wives, man, but all his wives, like his wives was fucking dope. Like, in just in general, like looking at it as an adult, his wives were fucking dope because, like, you had one that was like a career woman. You know what I'm saying? You had one that was for the community. You know what I'm saying? You had one that, you know, that was, you know, for him. You know what I'm saying? That nigga made so much money. You know what I'm saying? Like, all I know, that nigga was a consultant. He was a consultant that taught martial arts. That's all I knew. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, but looking at it now, it's like, damn, homie really had that shit. Like, his mind, he really had that shit locked down. And honestly, if I could talk to him as an adult, I would sit him down and be like, yo, like, you got to let me know why you chose to do that and why you chose that path, bro. Because I need to know. You know what I'm saying? I need to know.
Because, like, yeah, to me, like, as long as he's taking care of your needs.
Absolutely. And they were all taken care of.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
they didn't want for shit.
What's the problem? As long as he's taking care of your needs. Mm-hmm. Now, if having multiple women is a stress on him and he's not able to take care of your needs as if he was, if y'all was just whatever.
Yeah.
I get that. I get that. And even in, you know, our religion, they talk about, like, look, if you got multiple wives, you need to be able to provide for them. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Both, you know what I mean? Equally.
Yeah, because everybody, so y'all don't know, but being Muslim, if you have multiple wives, every one of them wives have to have their own house. And everybody has to be treated equal. So if you buy one a car, you got to buy the other one or the other two or three or four a car. Like, you have to, it has to be equal playing field across the fucking board. Has to be, you know? So, I mean, shit, in every book, in every major religion, it say be fruitful and multiply. That's what the fuck it says.
That's what it says.
That's what the fuck it says. Be fruitful and multiply. Pretty much God telling you to fuck. No, let me not say I'm going to hell. But no, he's saying be fruitful and fucking multiply, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to continue the fucking human race. That's really what it's saying. Continue the fucking human race, yo. You know what I'm saying? And we live in a society where, all right, we live in the United States where you're legally only able to have one wife. However, you can have shared power of attorney. You can have a will. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not being the second woman in a poly relationship. It's not as cumbersome. You know what I'm saying? As y'all make it out to be, because the first thing they try to argue is, oh, well, if something happened to this nigga, his wife get everything. No, if you go in there and be like, all right, nigga, I need to be put on this will. You know what I'm saying? I am the second wife. I need to be put on this will. I need to be on some legal documents. We live in a society where you can fucking do that. It's not hard. It's not hard at all. You come in there with your demands. If your demands ain't met, then fucking leave. You know what I'm saying? But who's going to argue with that? If you come in and you do your fucking job, who's going to argue with that? You know what I'm saying? The guy's going to push for it. The woman's going to push for it. Like, oh, yeah, she needs to be, baby, we need to put her on these documents. This is our woman. We need to put her on these fucking documents. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, it makes too much sense. That's why people don't want to, you know, go about it that way. You know what I'm saying? Like, we live in a society, like, we are in 7% inflation on everything right now after COVID. You know what I wouldn't do to kill to be in a fucking polygamous relationship right now with, you know what I'm saying, like, with the inflation how it is? Like, nigga, I like living comfortably. I live below my means so I can live comfortably. So this 7% inflation don't really affect me like that.
So I'm saying, sometimes you need a team, bro. Get on team newbie.
Stupid, man. You stupid. All right, man. So we got two more topics and we're gonna get out of here, man. So we talked about, we briefly touched on, you know, your partner slacking. And I know this is a big thing for women. You know, as men, you know, we do conform and get comfortable. And sometimes we slack. And, you know, are you, and women do the same thing. Like we said, you know, they kind of let their routines of looks kind of go. So is it possible that, you know, what we do is reward the slacking of our partners, for instance? You might bring it to your girl like, hey, yo, you know, you don't get your hair done like you used to. You're not keeping your grippers right. You know what I'm saying? Like, I kind of like it. Like, when you grip my dick, you know what I'm saying? Your nails is done. You know, like, you're, you know what I'm saying? Like, you putting on them cheap-ass press-on shits. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like, why you don't do that no more? Oh, nigga, if you did this, this, and that, I'd do it. Like, why am I rewarding you slacking? Why am I rewarding you slacking? You know what I'm saying? Like, one thing I will say about a relationship that I had, you know, if something slack, like, she would explain to me why. She was like, yeah, you know, I ain't had the money to get my nails done like I wanted to this week. I had to go to, you know, I couldn't go to Kiki. I had to go to, and shout out to Kiki, man. She be doing her thing. She's like, oh, I couldn't go to Kiki. I had to go to, you know, the Chinese ladies up the street and, you know, get like the, you know, it wasn't the style that I wanted. But you know what? I still appreciate you, you know what I'm saying, even putting forth that little bit of effort. But you know what? I got you this week. I'm going to cash app you $50. Go get your nails done. You know what I'm saying? Go get the style that you want. Right. You know what I'm saying? To make you feel comfortable. Because I like the way your hands look around my dick. Like, I love it when your fucking nails is done. Like, I love that shit. So, yeah, go get your nails done. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's that communication piece. You know what I'm saying? But why do we have to reward that slacking behavior? Because women are quick to say, oh, nigga, if you did this, this, and that, then I would do this, this, and that. No. Just because we're in a relationship together don't mean you get the slack. Same thing with guys. Don't mean we get the fucking slack.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like on both ends, no matter what your partner got going on, just make sure you're doing your part.
Right.
Make sure you're doing your part, because when you do this whole little tit for tat shit, y'all just going downhill. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not doing this, so I'm not going to do that. Like, yo, just do your part. Continue to do your part.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then that's going to give you leverage. You know what I'm saying? When the discussion does come up, because you can be like, listen, you know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. But if you come to her and you ain't doing your part, then the first thing she going to do is point the finger at you. You know what I'm saying?
So, that's right.
So you can legit walk away out the situation knowing that you did your part. You know what I'm saying? Versus being in the situation where you didn't do your part. And now, you know what I'm saying? Now y'all both in the wrong. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like fellas and ladies, like, no matter what's going on, just like, make sure you're doing your part. Like, ladies, make sure you're keeping yourself. Fellas, man, make sure your lady feels appreciated. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, always keep that shit going, because it's like, you know, otherwise y'all going to be going downhill, man, with that tit for tat joint. Now, because first you was mad, now she going to be mad because now you stopped doing what you should have been doing, mm-hmm. because she stopped doing what she should. So it was just one-sided. Now it's on both of y'all. And now that's going to be a snowball effect, and you're just going to go down the hill. So, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you're doing what you're doing, so that way when you have the conversation, you can legit be like, listen, you know, I'm trying my best over here, and you can say that honestly. You know what I mean? Because if you come at her and you're like, man, like, I really think you should be doing this and that, she's going to be like, well, nigga, you ain't doing it. You know what I'm saying? Just make sure you got all your ducks in order, so that
in a,
way.
In a fucking row, man. In a fucking row. Speaking of rewarding bad behavior, man, I hate makeup sex. I hate that shit. I hate makeup sex for the reason it reinforces that bad behavior. It reinforces, you know what? I had a relationship with a woman, a couple women, who glorified that shit, because I'm not a controversial person. I don't like to have drama and controversy, excuse me, if I'm in any kind of relationship. You know what I'm saying? I don't like to, I don't like to hold that mantle or be on that pedestal to where, you know, it's going to be disagreements with people. We have difference of opinion. It's going to be disagreements. However, I don't subscribe to arguments. Hate fucking arguments. We can have a debate, but having an argument is something that I don't do. So having a big blow up and then having makeup sex after, I don't subscribe to that shit. And I'm gonna tell you why, because all that does is reinforce the bad behavior that you just did. It's like your dog pissing on the carpet and you giving it a treat. Like, why would you do that? No, you rub his fucking nose in it, hit him two times with a newspaper. He knows, okay, if I piss on this carpet again, I gotta smell pee and get hit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's same thing with kids. You know, if they go to school and they show their ass, you beat their ass. You know, and I'm all for beating kids. Like, I'm just keeping beating. You know what I'm saying? Like, my kids will get popped. However, you know what I'm saying? It's just that brief, you know, expression of disappointment, because you never beat your kids out of anger. You beat them out of disappointment. Like, yo, you know fucking better. You know fucking better. You know what I'm saying? Same thing when you're training a dog. You know what I'm saying? You train a dog, you know what I'm saying? All right, well, look, you don't know better yet, but you about to know better. You know, you're training a puppy. When I had a dog, Diamond. I love Diamond to death, too. That was my girl, man. That was my girl. But when Diamond was a puppy, she used to piss on the fucking floor all the time. Instead of letting somebody know, she had to go outside. So what we do? Rub her nose in it, hit her two times, and then when she got older, she... Yo, I'm not pissing on this fucking floor. Somebody better take me out. It's three niggas in this house. I'm licking all hands that are hanging off of beds until somebody takes me out. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not going to piss on this floor.
That's legit.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I think makeup sex is bullshit. I don't know. What's your take on it, bro?
I couldn't agree with you more. Okay. I've actually been in a situation like that where we would have the worst arguments. Then Shirley would call me over. She'd be in something real sexy and shit. She'll feed me and shit.
Not apologize. You notice he didn't even say an apology.
Not even apologize. And just be like, I don't want to argue. I just want us to be friends. And I just want to go back to... Not discuss what happened at all.
Right.
And then we'd have sex after that. And then like, oh my God, I feel so much better. And then a few days later, same bullshit, yeah. Big ass argument. And we had sex. And then it's just like this. It's
a revolving door that I'm trying to get out of. Y'all ever been in those fucking revolving doors for like hotels and shit? You know what I'm saying? You trying to get out of that shit, but somebody pushing it fast as fuck. Like, you know, you trying to get out of that shit. Like, I don't want to be here anymore. I'm trying to get to my car. You know, like, why the fuck am I still in this fucking revolving door? No, man. No, I don't.
No, that shit is extremely, extremely toxic.
Yeah, I think that's probably the most toxic thing ever. Fucking makeup sex. Like,
yeah, I used to be like, oh, yeah, makeup sex. You know, you check all your frustrations. But nah.
No, because
not unless y'all actually worked out the problems.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. Yeah, like, absolutely.
Like the conversation should have been the makeup,
mm-hmm.
Not the sex. When the sex is the makeup, then no.
As younger me used to love makeup sex. You know what I'm saying? So okay, yeah, we're gonna argue, but once we, you know, come to a understanding, I'm like, okay, yeah, we about to have some, you know, we about to have some makeup sex, but. It shouldn't be like that, man.
When you was toxic and shit.
Yeah, I was toxic as fuck, man.
That shit, yeah, nah. I couldn't agree with you more. That shit is toxic, bro.
Yeah, man.
Stop that shit.
Y'all got to cut that shit out, man. I ain't got shit else, bro. I ain't got shit else in me, man.
Bro, I'm good, man.
All right. Well, look, man. We appreciate y'all listening, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to the Patreon. We got the Patreon going for $1. $1, $1, $1. So you can subscribe to the Patreon, become a family with us. We're actually going to do this, man. We're going to start calling y'all. We're going to start calling y'all. So if you subscribe to the Patreon, you will get access to our Discord, and you can drop a question and we will call you and we will talk about it. And that's going to be fucking interesting. So, you know, we're going to call you. We're going to talk about, you know, we're going to have you on the show. You're going to be on the pod. It's like you're going to be sitting right here, you know, but we will call you and we will talk about, you know, anything that you want to talk about, man. And that is for any Patreon tier. So whether you get the $1 tier or the $25 tier, we will take all of that, and, you know, into picking. So, not next week, but the week after next, we are going to start that, man, because I want to open the floor to a lot more of the people that, you know, kind of view our podcast and support us, man. And, you know, I mean, supporting us come with perks, man. You know, we got merch that we give away for free, man. You know, just out of the kindness of our heart, man. Just, you know, if you subscribe to us on Patreon, you know, if you keep us running, you know, if you keep my equipment up, you know what I'm saying, that we use for this podcast, these cameras, these lights, you know, this shit ain't cheap, man. So, you know, make sure that you subscribe to us and fucking tune in with us, man. So, you know, make sure you follow us on all social media platforms, man. Follow me, King Bach, KBNG, BAK. Follow my man, Primetime Naeem, Primetime_Naeem on Instagram. Also follow his podcast, Agree to Disagree, on Facebook and YouTube. And make sure you follow the podcast itself on Facebook and YouTube, Drinks and Discussion Podcast. Then, you know, give us a little follow on Twitter, man. You know, I might be late posting shit, but I try to do my best. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we got the clips on YouTube. I mean, not YouTube. We got the clips on Instagram and TikTok now. So, you know, make sure you follow us, man. DND Pod, man. Anything you want to say before we get out of here?
Man, I'm good, bro. Hey, appreciate y'all for watching.
Absolutely, man. We'll holler at y'all later. Peace.
Peace.